Hey, what's up guys, and welcome to the next installment in my brand new video series, Unlocking the Fretboard. Hope you guys have found these lessons helpful so far, and if you haven't done so already, I'd like to invite you to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button, as it really goes a long way in helping me to be able to continue to make these videos for you. But with all that out of the way, go ahead and grab your guitar, tune up, and let's get right into it. So we're going to start out by doing a little review of what we covered in our last lesson, which was note location. So if you guys haven't checked that out already, I highly suggest that. I will link that at the top of the screen right now. So if you guys have not checked that out, go ahead and click that and go through that lesson and then go ahead and come back to this one. So note location is going to play a really big part in the way we learn our scales, and we're going to get right into that. So note location is going to be a huge part of the way we learn how to play our scales, because that's going to give us our starting point for each of the positions that we learn our scales in. So let's real quick go over that. For today's lesson, we're going to use E. It's guitar player's favorite key. So we're going to go ahead and find all the places that E exists on the fretboard. So let's go ahead and start with our low open E. And then we're going to jump up to the 12th fret on that string, and we're going to have another E there. On our A string, we're going to have the 7th fret, and then we're going to have the 19th fret. On our D string, we're going to have the 2nd fret, and the 14th fret. And on the G string, we're going to have our 9th fret, and the 21st fret. And on the B string, we'll have the 5th fret, as well as the 17th fret. And our high E string is going to be open and 12th fret. Now, if you guys are playing 24 fret guitars, you can go ahead and include those 24th frets on the high E string and the low E string right here and here. But each of those spots is going to give us our starting position for each of these scales. Now, once we've located each of the places that the note we chose exists at, we're going to use each of those places to start building our scale from. Now, instead of doing this in closed position or three note per string, the difference here is we're going to use a different finger for each of these positions starting on that note. So I know that sounds a little confusing, but this is what it looks like. So say we're going to play E minor. That's our scale that we're choosing, E minor. We're going to start on, say, the 7th fret of the A string. And we're going to start that by using our pinky finger. So that's going to look like this. That'll be pinky on the 7th fret of the A string. And then on the D string, we'll have 4th, 5th, and 7th. And then on our G string, we'll also have the 4th, 5th, and 7th frets. And then on the B string, we'll have the 5th fret. So that position looks like this. All right, now let's go ahead and take our middle finger and put that on that starting A, I'm sorry, that starting E on the 7th fret of the A string. So now we're taking our pinky and we're switching our middle finger to that note. And that's gonna now look like middle finger, 7th fret of the A string, and then we're gonna go to 9th fret of the A string. D string is gonna be 5th, 7th, and 9th. And the G string is going to be 5th, 7th, and 9th. So all together. And now we can take that one step further, and now instead of our middle finger being on that note, we're going to put our first finger there. And now that's going to look like first is going to be 7th fret of the A string, and then we're going to have the 9th fret and then the 10th fret. Repeat that pattern on the D string, 7th, 9th, 10th. And then we'll have 7th and 9th on the G string. So altogether, that position looks like this. So now, essentially, we've just created three different ways that we can play an E minor scale, starting on just one of those notes we located, right? So here's our E that we found. And now here's each of the three scales that we just covered. All right, so if we've done all those positions on that one note, The next step would be to find all those other E's that we just located and do the same thing on each of those E's. So let's go ahead and take a look at how that looks. The next E we're going to choose to do this from is going to be our low open E. So nothing fretted there, just the open E string. And the first position we're going to do there looks like this. It'll be open, then we'll have second fret and then third fret on the low E. We'll have the same pattern on the A string. So that's open, second, third. On the D string, it'll be open and second. So that looks like this. Now we've got one more way we can play it down there. We're a little limited on the low end of the neck because we can only go so far that way. So the only other position we can do here is going to be, again, open E. And then we're going to go with our first finger, second fret. Then we'll have third fret and fifth fret. So that looks like this. And then we'll have second, third, and fifth on the A string. And then we'll have second on the D string. So all together. All right, so the next E that we're going to choose to build our scales from is going to be located at the second fret of the D string. Again, we're going to be a little bit limited here because we're at the bottom of the neck, so we're only going to be able to do two different positions here. So the first one's going to look like this. We'll have that second fret on the D string. And we're going to go ahead and actually play that with the middle finger. And then we're going to go to the fourth fret of the same string. And then the G string will be open, second, and fourth. The B string will be first and third. And then we're going to have an open E on top. So all together, that position looks like this. And then the next position, we're going to go ahead and put our first finger on that second fret of the D string. And we're going to have second fret, fourth fret, and fifth fret. And then we'll have the same pattern on the G string, second, fourth, and fifth. And then on the B string, we'll have third and fifth. So all together, that looks like this. Now we've already done all our positions that exist on the seventh fret of the A string. So we're gonna go ahead and switch up to our 12th fret on the E string. So we're gonna go ahead and put our pinky there. Remember, each position, we're gonna start on our pinky. So we'll have pinky on the 12th fret. On the A string, we'll have 9th, 10th, and 12th. Same pattern on the D string, 9th, 10th, and 12th. And then 9th on the G string. So all together, we have... All right, let's switch our pinky to the middle finger on that same note, 12th fret on the E string. So now we're going to have 12th fret, 14th fret. And then we're going to have 10th, 12th, and 14th on our A string. And then the same pattern on our D string, 10th, 12th, and 14th. So all together, that looks like this. All right, we've got one more position there. So that's going to be first finger instead of our middle on the 12th fret of the E string. And now our position, our pattern, I'm sorry, is going to be 12th, 13th and 14th. I'm sorry, 12th, 14th, and 15th. Same pattern on the A string, 12th, 14th, 15th. And then 12th and 14th on the D string. So all together, it looks like this. All right, so a quick review in that position, starting on the pinky. All right, so the next E we're going to use is going to be our E that exists on the 9th fret of the G string. And here we only have two ways we can play it. And for this one, we're going to go ahead and start with our third finger on that 9th fret of the G string. And on the B string, we're gonna have 7th, 8th, and 10th. And then on our high E string, we're gonna do something a little different here. We're gonna go 1st finger on the 7th fret of the E string, but we're going to slide into that 8th fret, and then we're gonna go middle on the 10th and pinky on the 12th. So all together, that position looks like this. All right, and then the next position, we're gonna have 1st finger on the 9th fret of the G string, and we're gonna have frets 9, 11, and 12. And then on our B string, we'll have 10, 12, and 11. And then on our high E string, we'll have 10 and 12. So all together, that position looks like this. Now, if we keep going any more past the 12th fret, these are just octaves, so the patterns are all going to be the same, repeating from what we did down here. So go ahead, and I want you guys to work on that yourself. I'm not going to give you all the answers here, but I have faith in you. You guys can do this. Now, we've located a bunch of different ways that we can play our E minor scale. The next step in here to become more fluent in this is going to be connecting each of those positions in a way that gets us from this end of the fretboard up here, right? So it's going to take a little bit of experimentation on your part, but I can give you an example of how that looks. So we're going to go ahead and use these positions that we've already created, and like I said, we're going to try to connect them. So go ahead and use your ears. Let your ears guide you on this. Remember, note location is huge on this. If you can find your notes, it's going to help you a ton. So here's an example of the ways you can do this. So starting on our low E string. Essentially, I'm just sliding from position to position as I move through these scales. So I'll kind of walk you through it again as I do this here. So on our low E string, we're going to take that 1st position, right? And now from that note, I'm going to go ahead and slide into my next position here, right? Now from here, I'm going to do another slide into my next position, right? Now that's one way you can do it. I would suggest try sliding on different strings too. That's going to be a big help. So don't always slide on the A string, for instance, when you switch from 1st position to 2nd position. Maybe try sliding on the low E string instead. So maybe something like this. Right? I'll give you another example here. So maybe we're going to slide on our D string now. So we'll have... And we can also experiment with this in other positions as well. So let's go ahead and start on maybe our pinky position of that 7th fret on the A string, right? So let's go ahead and do a slide from the pinky, from that 7th fret to the 9th fret. So it might look like this. So like I said, it's going to take some experimentation on your part. I would say practice the positions individually, how we went over throughout this entire lesson. And once you get those down, then go ahead into that experimentation phase and try connecting each of these positions through various slides on different strings. And then our final step, probably the most important step out of everything we've covered today, is going to be application, which is using these in a musical way. Rather than just playing our scales ascending and descending, we want to use these in a way that's musical, right? So my suggestion for you is backing tracks. Backing tracks are a really great tool. In one of my previous videos, I talked about elevated jam tracks. He makes really, really, really good backing tracks, and he also has the chords displayed on the screen for you, so that's a huge help. So I would say go ahead and use those backing tracks. I'll link them in the description below. And try to use all these positions once you've gotten them down and practiced them and you've worked on experimenting with connecting them. Go ahead and practice, you know, your phrases and your melodic lines over your backing track. And that should get you to a point where you're comfortable enough to move around the fretboard with ease in one key without playing wrong notes and playing good lines. That's going to wrap up our lesson on scales today, guys. I hope this is helping you guys out a ton. I hope you guys are finding some use out of this. Don't forget to experiment and have fun with this and use those backing tracks. They are going to help you out a ton, all right? If you guys aren't already subscribed to my channel, I highly suggest you do that as it helps me to be able to continue to make these videos for you. Don't forget to smash that like button, leave a comment. If you guys have questions, go ahead and leave those in the comments as well. And I'll see you in the next one.